Welcome to E.ON Hanse AG in Greifswald, Germany. On the basis of over 100 years of experience with gas supply in the region, we are responsible in the Netzcenter Greifswald as a grid company for own station and grids of the gas supply for Pommern. This includes about 1,000 kilometers gas lines, 100 gas pressure regulating stations and 50,000 customers. By saying we is meant 23 colleges at two locations in the region. On the basis of our regional center in Schwerin, this location is starting point for the pilot project for condition-based maintenance at gas pressure regulating stations. The purpose of this presentation is to inform you, by means of this short film, about an innovative test and diagnostic system that we developed in close cooperation with the company Kamstrup from Holland. Condition-based maintenance at gas pressure regulating stations means that contrary to our today's practice and set of rules, maintenance at regulators and safety devices do not take place necessarily at regular time intervals any longer. The technical condition of the devices and components is normative for the maintenance actions. In order to determine the condition of a station, it is necessary to use measuring technology with a very high accuracy. One of the goals of our development was to create a standardized test sequence and output of error-free reproducible data. This idea was realized in cooperation with the company Kamstrup and resulted in an inspection system consisting of Plexo test equipment and specialized software. In the following example, our inspector will execute a functional test of a gas pressure regulating station with Plexo. This gas pressure regulating station for the local gas distribution of the gas supply for Pommern GmbH operated at an inlet pressure of 11 bars and an outlet pressure of 40 millibar. The station has a capacity of 2,500 non-cubic meters in an hour. The downstream grid has a length of 15 kilometers. In order to make reliable and safe connection between the Plexo test equipment and the components of gas station, it is necessary to install a number of couplings in this gas station. These couplings have, depending upon the type, a pressure rating up to 100 bars. The installation of the couplings takes place in the already existing measuring points in the station. Old measuring couplings and connections are removed when assembling the new couplings. An innovation is the coupling for the slam shut device, which is installed directly in the sense line of the slam shut device. The Plexo test equipment of the company Kamstrup was launched about 7 years ago and developed in the course of the years to its present state. Two digital pressure gauges with an accuracy of 0.05% are two essential components in the test equipment. Because these pressure gauges are calibrated and certified, the accuracy of the measuring data is ensured. The measuring data are sent via a wireless interface to explosion-proof PDA. Apart from the pressure gauges, the test equipment has a series of connectors to make connections to the individual components of the gas station. The joystick, which is visible here in the picture, serves as a control for error-free functional test of the slam-shut devices. The test equipment can be applied for outlet pressure up to 16 bars. The PDA serves as data storage and as a means of communication with the two pressure gauges. In addition, the software in this PDA leads the inspector in a sequential way through the functional test procedure. Before the actual test begins, the Plexo test equipment has to be connected to the gas line to be tested. First of all, vent hose has to be connected. This guarantees that no gas can escape into the station, but is led to the outside world in a safe way. By means of stainless steel hoses, the test equipment is connected to the inlet and outlet pressure as well to the sense line of the slam shut device. By a snapping system at the Plexo test equipment and by simple street connection at the couplings, it is uncomplicated to make the connections. After having connected the test equipment to the gas station, the inspector is ready to start the test. The software installed in the PDA leads the inspector through the functional test. In the database of this software, the relevant data of all gas stations in the territory of the inspector are stored, as well as the results of the previous test. After having selected the gas station to be tested, the inspector receives instructions about his further actions. The test begins with a function test of the pressure regulator. The flow pressure of the regulator is simulated by opening the vent. The pressure values can be read directly in the display of the PDA. The succession of the gate time areas is presented in the display of the PDA. At the end of the measuring cycle, storage of the data takes place. If the measured values are outside the entered tolerances, a message appears in the display immediately. After all functional aspects of the regulator were tested, the test of the slam shut device follows without any delay. For this test, the already mentioned joystick is operated, causing an even pressure increase of approximately 1.5% per second in the sense line of the slam shut device. The pressure rise starts from the initial outlet pressure. The measuring data are released and stored, and the inspector is instructed to reset the slam shut device. Later, the leakage of the slam shut device is tested. For this purpose, the outlet pressure is lowered. The leakage at the valve seat is measured. The test of the gas line is finished now. The inspector gets the instruction to prepare the test of the pressure relief valve. This part of the test procedure included the testing of the set point, the lock-up pressure, the capacity, as well as the leakage against the atmosphere of the pressure relief valve. Apart from recording the set point and the leakage values, the PDR writes a data log file in order to enable a graphic evolution of the entire functional test afterwards. The supervisor has the possibility to read all data of the accomplished test and compare this with the results of the previous test. Any failure found in the gas station is immediately reported to the operator in order to start a repair procedure for the component in question. Later, the components are submitted for a repeated partial inspection. The following test with Plexor is limited only to the components concerned. An evolution of the electric data takes place via an operator at the respective location.
Hallo. Grüß dich. Arbeit folge.
Jo.
The data communication with the PC of the operator takes place by means of RF technology.
Jetzt können Sie aus dem Rechner schwenken.
During the data communication, the measuring data exchange and the master data of the gas station are supplemented. For processing and evolution purposes, the data are stored in a database on a central server. In order to make a uniform workflow possible, the measuring data are transferred into a asset management system SAP, which generates reports and files these automatically. The second way of evaluating the data takes place by means of the software developed by the company Campstrup. This software presents the results of the test in the form of a pressure diagram. By evaluating the data, the condition of the gas station is determined and, if necessary, medium-term measures are taken. By means of the mentioned pressure diagram, the results can be compared to equipment manufacturer specification as well to individual standards. According to our experience during several years, an evolution by means of the pressure diagram proved to be the best way of indicating the weak points of a station. The mentioned diagrams are filed in the SAP also. The test and evolution system present by us in this film is a powerful tool for collecting highly exact and error-free data. The evolution and use of the data lead to the goal of condition-based maintenance at gas pressure regulating systems. In the year 2005, E.ON Hanse AG will provide all gas stations in the regional center Schwerin with the mentioned couplings. The planning for the year 2006 included all remaining gas stations of E.ON Hanse. Experience gathered so far indicate that data of 3 years are needed to justify a prolongation of the maintenance intervals.